te reo aroha, ki te whānau e kawea mai, te wairua o tamae, ki te whakanui tōna mahi whakahirahira e, aroha nui ki a koutou e, whakaeke mai rā koutou e, ngā koutou e kai ana I te mātauranga e, ki te pai atu I ngā tapuai o koutou tīpuna e, whakaeke mai rā narunga I te mana o whānau e tautoko ana I a koutou e, haere mai rā he.
Tato, please be seated. Me timata tato I te tangiata pipi whirauro mo te wā kana nei, no reira ko te tangi, kui, whiti ora, whiti ki runga, whiti ki raro, whiti ki te whai au ki te ao marama ti hei mauri ora. Tēnā rā koutou, no mai haramai. Kua haramai nei tātou ki te whakanui, ngā taura o te whare wāringo Waitaha kei raro. Nō reira, ki ngā tauira e mihi ana ki a koutou, koe e ke pānuku, e ke tangaro, nō koutou te rangi nei. Nō reira, ki ngā whānau katoa, kua hare taiwhiti mai nei ki te tautoko, I tō koutou tamariki mokopona hoa, kei te mihi tātou ki a koutou. Tēnei mātua tū auhuri, ngai tahu o te whare wāringo Waitaha hoki, kei te mihi tātou ki a koutou katoa, nō reira, haramai, no mai, kia ora tātou. It's a pleasure for ngai tahu to welcome you who have travelled from near and afar for this graduation, for the celebration at Te Whare Wāringo Waitaha at the University of Canterbury. So graduates, while we are here to celebrate your triumphs and achievements, it's also important that we acknowledge your wider family, your friends, who have supported you with your efforts. So again, on behalf of Tuahuriri, Ngai Tahu, the University of Canterbury, no mai, haere mai, piki te ora.
wero I a ki te pō te ra ka katau re 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 katau mai te ruhi e tau e ko I a ko I a ko ta rarauri ki ki mai maui e hara I te whitu me te waru e e tau e ko I a ko I a.
That kinaki was a song of Maui celebrating finally the coming of spring. It's a time to celebrate family, your success. Kia ora, piki te ora, piki te kaha, piki te maramatanga. Congratulations.
Ka tangi te titi, ka tangi te kaka, ka tangi hoki aho, tihe Māori ora. E te mana whenua, nei tuahuriri, tēnā koutou. Rauranga tira mā, nau mai, piki mai, haere mai, ki te whare wānanga o Waitaha. Ko Amy Adams ahu, ko o Tutumu Konihera I te whare wānanga o Waitaha. I welcome you to the University of Canterbury and invite all present to stand, remove trenches, and join in the singing of the Māori and English versions of the first verse of the national anthem, which are in the back of your programs and displayed on the screens behind me. Please be seated. Kia ora anō. Can I begin by acknowledging our Vice-Chancellor, Professor Cheryl Dararay, and our pou, whakarai, Professor Tamari Tau, the members of our University Council, the members of our academic fraternity, staff of UC, family and friends of our graduates, and most importantly, our graduates. It is a great privilege to welcome you all here today. So firstly, to the graduates, my sincere congratulations on what you have achieved. I know your family will be very proud of you, and I encourage you to take time today to reflect on your accomplishments and feel that same pride in what you have achieved. We know that education stretches far beyond the academic. It encompasses a wide range of other skills that are developed along the way, and all of you graduating here today know this better than most. Amidst the many uncertainties and challenges of the past 2.5 years, you've persevered. Two words spring to mind when I think about you all: resilience and adaptability. These attributes are almost always forged from some pretty tough life lessons, but they are invaluable characteristics that I have no doubt will serve you well in years to come in all aspects of your life and career. Underpinning these aspects of character is the world-class education you received at the University of Canterbury, where we are always evolving to meet the demands of a rapidly changing world. The very nature of higher education, its delivery, relevance, and impact, as well as the role of universities in society, is expected to change dramatically in the years ahead, and our adaptation as an organisation throughout these past years demonstrates our own agility and responsiveness to new challenges. As an institution, we've had to adapt right alongside you to the challenges of a COVID-affected world. And like you, we haven't let this distract us from our goals. As we head towards marking the university's 150th year next year, we are now proud to have the highest number of enrolments in our history and to be ranked number one in the world for the UN Sustainability Development Goal 12. We're determined to remain agile, responsive, and pioneering, pushing boundaries to meet the evolving needs of our students so that you will always be able to reflect with pride on being a graduate of the University of Canterbury. Today, you can probably only begin to imagine where your degree will take you. As a graduate of UC myself, I know that when I was sitting where you are now, it would have been impossible to comprehend all of the possibilities that lay ahead. I encourage you to keep your hearts and your minds open as you think about the difference you will make in the world. Congratulations to all the graduates here today and to those who couldn't attend in person. Thank you to your lecturers and your tutors who have taught and guided you, and to your whānau and friends who have supported you, encouraged you, and picked you up when you needed it most. Wherever your journey takes you, in Aotea or around the world, we wish you all fulfilling and happy futures. We know how hard you've worked, how committed and dedicated you are. Welcome to the University of Canterbury alumni. He mihi nui ki a koutou katoa. In the name of Te Whare Wānanga o Waitaha, University of Canterbury, I, Amy Juliet Adams, Tumu Konihera, Chancellor, now convene a ceremony of the University of Canterbury to celebrate our graduates on the completion of their certificates, diplomas, and degrees. I call upon our Tumu Tuhurua Rangahau, Deputy Vice-Chancellor Ian Wright, and Tumu Tuhurua Akoranga, Deputy Vice-Chancellor Academic Catherine Moran, to introduce those who will present the graduates. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa.
Chancellor, I invite the Associate Dean of Postgraduate Research, Professor Ekant Veer, to call upon the doctoral graduates.
Morena tātou. Doctoral degrees are the highest academic qualifications offered and awarded by the University of Canterbury. They are a mark of intellectual ability, critical thinking, and independence. In your graduation program, there is a short description of the research conducted by each of the doctoral graduates. As each graduate walks across the stage, the title of their doctoral thesis will appear on the screen, and members of their supervisory team here on stage will stand to acknowledge the student's achievements. Chancellor, I have the honour to present these graduates for recognition by you as Chancellor and the University Council. Doctor of Philosophy, Adil Bilal in Information Systems. Sir Yi Chen in Taxation. Sina Kithiona Cotter Tate in Management. Vo Thi Hong Diem in Economics. Bonola Bacola Ogun Koya in Loya. Mohammed Ibn Khaldun Sitampol in law. Zhong Cheng Song in economics. Muthushi Tana in management. And my student, Afshin Tanuri in marketing.
I invite the Executive Dean of Business, Professor Paul Ballantyne, to call upon the graduates in his school.
Chancellor, I have the honour to present these graduates for recognition by you as Chancellor and the University Council. Master of Commerce with Distinction, Catherine Mary Mecca Sahid. Joshua Mark Ryan. Master of Business Administration with Distinction, Rochelle Marie Salceta. Karen Lee Churchwood. Case James Augustine Craig. Sarah Joy Kinane. Tracy Marie Robinson. Luke Johan Vandenbroek. Master of Business Administration with Merit, Deborah Joy Brown. Prince Alex. Matthew George Robinson. Niraj Vikash Ryan. Michael Munyemo. Master of Business with Distinction, Matthew Simon Cotter. George Francis Verity Patterson. Master of Business with Merit, Gracie Ann Bush. Isabella Louise Pownell. Catherine Ann Petra Waller. Yang Chen Wong. Ning Shu. Master of Business, Jessica Ann Meads. Ranvijay Singh Sisodia. Master of Business Management with Merit, Freddie Painter. Sashank Takar. Master of Business Management, Thais Vishenfelder Camargo. Master of Business Information Systems with Distinction, Tanvi Rohit Toprani. Master of Business Information Systems, Virashri Bhushan Shinda. Wow. Master of Professional Accounting with Merit, Jing Yi Wong. Si Yu Zhong. Master of Financial Management, Simon Matthew Allen Milne-Foot. Master of Applied Finance and Economics with Distinction and Bachelor of Commerce, Thomas Jochen Hawley. Joseph Paul Turnbull. Master of Applied Finance and Economics with Distinction, Brendan Fletcher. Harry Julian Hart Mitchell. Harry Daniel Mates. Postgraduate Diploma in Business, Montgomery Hugh Charles Bachelor. Mohita Chahan. Chien Ni Hung. Wei Biao Pun. Postgraduate Diploma in Business Information Systems, Bekaran Singh. Postgraduate Certificate in Business, Grace Holly Cortegast. Carl Pietrus Swart. Postgraduate Certificate in Strategic Leadership, Sharon Tracy Chapman Steed. Nicola Jane McMillan. Melanie Zeidel. Bachelor of Commerce and Bachelor of Health Sciences, Emily Rose Brownie. Bachelor of Commerce and Bachelor of Product Design, Scott Douglas Summer. Bachelor of Commerce and Certificate in Science, Jack Matthew Clive Kendall. Bachelor of Commerce and Bachelor of Sport Coaching, Lydia Rose Toddle. Bachelor of Commerce, Mohammed Najmi Abdul Rahim. Marian Mohammed Abdi. Herni Yasmin Binti Abdul Aziz. Sara Al-Hawani. Parmeet Singh Anand. Josh Dean Anderson. Callum Michael Angus. Mustafa Anis Nordin. Jayanafi Leanne Codera Aquino. Connor Bruce Ballantyne. William Thomas Beltus. Amy Elizabeth Beaver. James Albert William Beckwith. Natalie Briggs. Jordan Rex Brown. Jamie Corin Burrows. Jesse Liam Kane. Thomas Parker Joseph Carroll. Brian Lai. Louis Guy Clayton. Holly Georgina Cochran. Millicent Kai Collins. Benjamin Robert Crowley. Lara Frances Cunningham. Rosa Eileen Dalgleish. Alistair Sheowen Davidson. Alexander Philip Xavier Davis. Andre John DeRose. Jamie Daniel Dearden. Victor Manuel de Filiero Castillo. Matthew Patrick Henry Dennis. Sophie Elizabeth Coots Dickerson. Henry Thomas Dobbs. Jacob Scott Edridge. Grace Harriet Eglinton. Ellen. Hannah Kate Ellingham. Jack Stuart Engel. Grace Helen Evans. Jordan Lee Fairbrother. Jenna Kate Fellows. Ophelia Winsome Kim Fish Simmons. Callum Ryan Ferguson. Georgina Jane Edith Foster. Robert Stewart Freeben. Ellen Adrian Florendo Galang. Megan Emma Gillett. Jacob Andrew Gilligan. Jack Robert Gillen. Liam John Goodwin. Emma Judith Grace. Alexandra Sylvia Green. Rishu Gupta. Alice Jane Hanrahan. Jordan Kenneth Hart. Samuel John William Hill. William Isaac Holden. Isabel Sophia Ingram. Brianna Champagne James. Haley Zara Jenkinson. Oliver David Jenks. Bridget Katina Johnston. Sophie Amelia Johnston. Si Ting Jong. Cameron William Jobson. Jan Joachimus Jordan. Holly Jessica Kennedy. Lucy May Kennedy. Lukesh Edward Kidd. Hong Sik Kong. Brent La. Keanu Jed Madrigal Labahu. Rebecca Emily Lake. Josh Robert John Lennox. Lily Victoria Lloyd. William Iparana Hunter McDonald. Hamish Patrick Lee McPherson. George John Manitin. Hamish Mansur. Meg Alexandra Marshall. Cameron Sean Maxwell. Andrew James Garside McCliskey. Kyle Bernard McLaughlin. Taylor Russ McClellan. Ashley Connor McNichol. Patrick Liam McSorley. Emily Frances Mills. Ewan Osborne Milnes. Maisara Binti Mohammed Azri. Nursaira Binti Mohammed Mayuddin. Nadira Batrisaya Mohammed Noor Hisham. Sara Amalia Binti Mohammed Zainarin. Amar Mohammed Viti Dodwala. Hannah Francis Monk. Olivia Jane Morgan. Laura Grace Nichols. Leo William Anthony Nordinus. Jade Junior Nawata Apahola. Anna Maria Catherine O'Callaghan. Harrison Peter Olds. Samuel James Pasco Patterson. Carmen Shea Paklowski. Scott Nicholas Rees. Amedia Mariwa Lee Reed. Joshua David Reed. Hugh Tate Renton. Jacob Alex Richardson Van Wigan. Danielle Eileen Robb. Juliet Amy Lee Robinson. Sarah Olivia Routon. Tahu Paul Russell. Sarah Tess Ryan. Logan John Edward Sanko. Watafoti Sa'ofai. Jeremy Lorenzo Peter Scholar. Harrison Fleming Seawood. Lucas Fleming Seawood. Siti Nadira Binti Sheikh Abdul Rahman. Vicky Alpesh Shah. Kairunisa Binti Shaiful Kairi. Matthew Philip Shivas. Jordan Hugh Smith. Zoe Linda Helen Smith. Lily Margaret Stevenson. Hunter James Stewart. Jordan Tyler Suckling. Jared Thomas Swinburne.
Tēnā koutou katoa, no hane kari o, ko Dunau te awa, ko Madyar te iwi, ko Adelikados tokoingoa, ko o te pōroki, no reira tēnā koutou katoa. Greetings, assembled guests. My name is Adelikados and I am the Registrar of the University. It is my pleasure to introduce a musical performance by the students and staff of the University of Canterbury School of Music. The musical piece is called Hope and was composed in 2020 by guitarist Freddie Gash. Hope premiered at the Nelson Composers Workshop of that same year. It is composed for the unconventional combination of string quartet and electric guitar and conveys a journey from hardship to healing. Please join me in welcoming Michaela Flenner on first violin, Aya McClarty on second violin, Professor Mark Mendes on viola, Amy McMurdo on cello, and composer and guitarist Freddie Gash. Thank you.
Bachelor of Commerce, Sarah Lynn Taylor. Panisara Tumasila. Sydney Marie Thomas. Ryan Shelford Thompson. Nicholas Ian Thornley. Freya Grace Trilofili. Lily Madeline Trotter. Sin Chen Sai. Caitlin Louisa Van der Gulick. Darius van Veek. Kittis McQuanant Wale. Bridie Shannon Walsh. Juan Izat Razi Binwan Fazwari. Yu Wong. Jonathan Stephen Watkins. Amy Mary Westall. Holly Joy Weaver. Chloe Angela Webb. James Patrick Garty Whelans. Amy Louise White. Mitchell Adrian White. Sarah Kate Wigley. Ben Patrick Williams. Samuel Guy Williams. Fergus Hart Williamson. Jenna Paige Willicks. Rachel Carolyn Winder. Matthew Robert Wongcam. Kate Ellen Woollett. Kate Mary Woolmore. Pan Pan Xiong. Yishin Shu. Alison Miriam Yi. Chiyuzu Yin. Mohammed Hanif bin Zainal Abidin. Xinyu Zhong.
I invite the Executive Dean of Law, Professor John Page, to call upon the graduates and his faculty.
Chancellor, I have the honour to present these graduates for recognition by you as Chancellor and the University Council. Master of Laws with First Class Honours, Cameron Mitchell Ead. Master of Laws, Christina Kosova. Master of Laws, International Law and Politics with First Class Honours, Beatrice May Holman. Master of Laws, International Law and Politics with Second Class Honours, Division 1, Brooke Francis McGowan. Bachelor of Laws with First Class Honours and Bachelor of Arts, Ella Ruth Hawkey Daith. Bachelor of Laws with First Class Honours and Bachelor of Commerce, Shasta Marie Gandhi. Sydney Lee Mallon Piper. Bachelor of Laws with Second Class Honours, Division 1 and Bachelor of Commerce, Jared Henry Chin. Bachelor of Laws with First Class Honours and Certificate in Commerce, Hayley Grace Stevens. Bachelor of Laws and Bachelor of Arts, Brianna Grace Bray. Alexandra Rose Buchanan. Laura Ruth Compton. Kelsey Ellen Iris Harris. Ella Rose Hegarty. Suyang Jung. Elizabeth Francis Marney. Victoria Ann Reed. Kurt Lucas Ian Shipley. Tamaho Luke Toms. Bachelor of Laws and Bachelor of Commerce, Emily Grace Cordwell. Jaden Scott Anthony Chan. Madeline Julia Craig. Jules Lance House. Caitlin Stewart Hogan. Emily Jean Hughes. Keegan Roy Jones. Leanne Deborah Jones. Callum William Kilgore Aitken. Hannah Alicia McMullen. Nicholas Cornelis Willem van Rooyen. David Joseph Wakefield. Rambadijai Mitchell Zainani. Bachelor of Laws and Bachelor of Criminal Justice. Benjamin Robert Delaney. Jung Ho Wang. Taylor Rose Grace Logan. Callum John Mitchellmore. Tavia Annie Mary Moore. Roma Alice Northcote Paletti. Natasha Kate Ryan. Bachelor of Laws and Bachelor of Science, Olivia Charlotte Gunn. Jessica Jean McDonald. Claudia Jane Prescott. Bachelor of Laws with First Class Honours, Valeria Julia Benjamin. Angus Robert William Dysart Paul. Julia Catherine Gunn. Sophie Joanne Harrison. Jack William Murison. Courtney Ann Palmer. Jacob Andrew Poff. Sarah Alexandra Victoria Pride. Grace Marie Watson. Bachelor of Laws with Second Class Honours, Division 1, Emily Rachel McElroy. Emma Mary McMorrin. Bachelor of Laws, James Linnaeus Alexander. Emily Grace Barnes. Rob Michael Duca Bautista. Josephine Molly Berliner. Alice Patricia Bevan, Georgina Frances Bolton, Alexandria Charlotte Kalinikos, Suksom Neng Chia, Pierce Jack Daniel Crowley, Rachel Kim Delahunty, Jessamae Daisy Joan Donnelly, Simone Michelle Margaret Gale, Zoe Diane Gilpin, Isabella Elizabeth Ann Gurin, Edward Erasmus Gurney, Brenna Rose Hadley, James Terence Hamilton, Victoria Jane Helms, Jaira Logos Hong, Rebecca May Hunter-Kelson, Sujin Jung, Harry John Reginald Linsky, Holly Celeste Mackle, Olivia Holly Manniton, Claudia Lily Mark, Isabella Jane McPhail, Samuel Ho Sheng Na, Billy Howard O'Connor, Lepasiofa, Stephanie Rachel Patient, Sondas Ahmad Yusuf Karan, Milan Rosabella Richmond, Corey Regan Shaw, Sejul Vasanti Shivla, Grace Lee Steinmetz, Charlotte Rose Brooker Stephen, Madeline Kate Thomas, Rebecca Grace Thomas, Emily Tien Tran, Lewis Jonathan Webb, Jordan David Bruce Whiteley, Alexandra Robin White, Indiana Paige Williams, Annabelle Jean Hurd Wilson, Thomas Bradley Wilson, Master of Criminal Justice with Distinction, Alicia Mary Rose Craig, Eleanor Jade Parkinson, Alana Jane Quinlivan, Master of Criminal Justice with Merit, Geneva Isabel Forrest. Angus Stephen Willens. Master of Criminal Justice, Shannon Sue. Bachelor of Criminal Justice, Sophie Maikai Aranik. Brooke Hazel Barry. Hannah Jane Bell Brady. Sophie Loren Buxton. Fiona Catherine Carrington. Tyler Marie Clark. Harrison Fisk Diljum. Emma Margaret Eggers. Jade Michelle Ferguson. Zoe Caitlin Harding. Grayson Suzanne Hazley Ewens. Georgia Isabella Hendry. Anine Karina Jarman. Chloe Emma Jenkins. Alice Anna Roberts Kenmar. Sally Jean Lorenzen. Julia Lisa Suweya Manulela Yua. Sarah Brittany McAgony. Jamie Lee McGahn. Jake Robert Miller. Caitlin Rose Moreland. Neve Marie Mullaney. Thomas Eric Noonan. Dylan Null Okidusko Brown. Grace Irene Parkin. Olivia Sydney Parsonson. Athena Angela Pilcher. Jack Tobias Owen Quinn. Kiana Ataria Rerekura Teto. Anna Claire Robson. Epinaru Ortolini Tariu. Anna Maria Eliana Tulia. Amy Lauren Williamson. Certificate in Criminal Justice, Chris Lee Johnston.
Assembled guests, it's my pleasure to now introduce the graduate address speaker, Tiffany Sauni. Tiffany graduated from the University of Canterbury in 2009 with the Bachelor of Laws and was admitted in the Supreme Court of Samoa and the High Court of New Zealand in 2010. Following graduation, she began her career at the Attorney General's Office of Samoa. During her time there, she undertook criminal prosecution work, civil and commercial litigation, as well as legislative drafting. Tiffany migrated to Otatahi, Christchurch in 2014 and now works as a senior associate at Shine Lawyers. Assembled guests, please join me in welcoming Tiffany Sauni to the lectern.
E mua mua ona o whatu lau I le paia maualunga o tātou mafutanga nei tai au. O te whatu lau fo'i I le awhio o lau fionga le pule ao ao o le University of Canterbury. Lau awhionga, Chancellor Amy Adams. Awhio fo'i lau awhionga, Vice-Chancellor Professor Cheryl Delaray. Awhio fo'i lau awhionga, General Counsel and Registrar Adele Cardos. O te whātū lau fōi, I le paia o le nei ele ele, o tangata whenua o le nei unofuanga. Ngā mihi ki nā tangata whenua o Aotearoa, mai I te ika o Maui, tai noa ki te wai puanamu. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Tālofa lava, and warm greetings to you all this morning. Now that I have the formalities out of the way, having addressed you in my mother tongue, Samoan, and also acknowledging the tangata whenua o Aotearoa, New Zealand, I'm asking myself, how can I inspire and motivate you, the graduates, as you embark on the next phase of your lives? It is an absolute honor and privilege to be able to address you all today. Today marks the day you reach the end of your formal education. Your degree or degrees will be conferred upon you and you will be released from this distinguished educational institution, armed and qualified to aim for those lofty goals you all no doubt have. I am sure that some of you in the audience have expected someone famous or perhaps a notable figure to be addressing you on such an auspicious occasion today. What I will say is that in 2004, I met The Rock, Dwayne Johnson. He's also my cousin. And that there are many world-famous people in Samoa in my hometown of Apia. I'm second cousins with three times removed. So by association, I possibly might fit the brief. Anyway, I do hope I do better at inspiring you, the graduates, today than I have with my terrible jokes. I get it from my dad. He's a lawyer, too, and a UC graduate. And his jokes, I assure you, are far worse. Who are you, I hear you all asking, apart from being The Rock's cousin? I'm so glad you asked. I mean, who doesn't like a license to talk about themselves and actually have people listen or appear to anyway? My name is Tiffany Jane Fa'alaitawa Nelson Sauni. I was born and raised in Samoa, and I'm a proud daughter of Samoa. I'm one of five children, the middle one, and clearly the funniest. I came to Christchurch when I was 17 years old to pursue studies at UC for an LLB. I was fortunate enough to be awarded a government scholarship. And initially I was told when I was awarded the scholarship that I would be attending Victoria University. With all due respect to Victoria and New Zealand's capital, Christchurch had the better rugby team. I also opted for the city of the Red and Blacks, the champions. I also have something in common with you all today, the graduates. From the point at which you are conferred now your doctorates, postgraduate or undergraduate degrees today, we both become alumni of this distinguished university. Like any good lawyer, I point out my conflict And I proudly flaunt my bias, but I think UC is the best university in New Zealand, yes? Yes? Although I'm not sure how my colleagues in Victoria and Auckland, Otago and Waikato may feel about that conclusion. As you've heard, I spent the first 4 years of my career as a criminal prosecutor and a state solicitor at the Office of the Attorney General in Samoa. Second only to my husband and parenting my three beautiful children, the first 4 years of my career were the steepest learning curve I have experienced in my life. I was working 80-hour weeks, doing at least a trial a week. I had some civil litigation, some criminal work, as you've heard, a bit of legislative drafting, and anything else that was thrown at me. But thankfully, due to my education here at UC, I arose to the challenge. It was a very rich learning experience that I am so grateful for, and lessons learned from my first job stay with me today. As you've also heard, I'm currently working as a civil litigator, as a senior associate at a firm called Shine Lawyers. I also happen to be a UC alumni ambassador for my home nation of Samoa. Being a UC ambassador allows me to give back to the institution that qualified me in the first place, but also to give back to my Samoan people, helping them too in a small way to their path to success. A warm and hearty graduation congratulations to you all on your graduation today. Congratulations for navigating the long and windy, up and down, side to side, cram and COVID-ridden road to success. You made it. All the late nights, all the long hours of study at the loft, the frantic pre-exam cramming sessions, the tutorials, the countless cases, including my personal favorite, Donahue and Stevenson, the lectures, the seminars, the endless hours of proofreading, the grammar checks, the word counting, the word removing, the conclusions, the formatting. Congratulations, you did it. I now turn to congratulate your villagers. Whilst everyone here will have a story that is uniquely yours, you also all each have something in common. Someone, somewhere, and at some point in this journey, believed in you, pushed you, invested in you. These people I would describe as your village, and we are all familiar with the phrase that it takes a village to raise a child. Well, it turns out that child rearing continues well after university graduation. If you are lucky and blessed enough today to have your village here with you, give them a high five, a hug, a we did it, and a we did it together. And don't forget to say thank you. Remember, whilst today is most certainly about your success and the hard work you have put in, it is also about those around you who helped you get here. After all, the best gift we can give back to our village for all they have done for us is to walk the road to success boldly, as you have done today. To the graduates, spouses, partners, parents, grandparents, uncles, aunts, sisters, brothers, families, and friends, congratulations to you also. As someone who, like today's graduates, also walked the same road to graduation here at UC, I understand the sacrifices you have made in order for our graduates to get here and walk across this stage. Their success today is as much theirs as it is yours. Now, coming back to my brief today, to inspire and motivate you, the graduates. The logical sequence for me to get to the inspiring is to share with you who inspires me. Now, I've been blessed in my personal and professional life with great mentors and people that have molded me, bad jokes and all, to the person and the lawyer I am today. There are many, but I have been given a strict 5-minute time limit, so I'll only share two with you. The first person who inspires me is my dad. My journey at UC actually started long before I was born. My father also attended UC in the 1970s and pursued an LLB and graduated in 1978 before moving back to Samoa where he began his practice of law. He did so until he was elevated to the bench in the year 2000, where he currently still sits as a sitting Supreme Court Justice of the Supreme Court of Samoa. He's heavily involved in children's rights. He currently sits as Samoa's representative to the UN for the Convention for the Rights of the Child Committee. As I said, his jokes are terrible, but I have to say, I get my great taste in rugby from him. He is also involved in many, many projects back home, giving a voice to the voiceless, having a hand in setting up the Samoa Victim Support Group in the early 2000s. That group helps with many children who are victims of sexual offending to find safety for them during the course of criminal proceedings against the offenders. He also works tirelessly to ensure the children of Samoa, my home nation, are given a voice. Through his UN work, he ensures that the children of the world are given a voice. His passion to make a difference never fails to motivate me to be better, to think bigger, and remember that I am so privileged to hold the same tools that he does to help others. The second person who has inspired me professionally is the late Andrew Hooker. Andrew Hooker was somewhat of a legend in insurance litigation circles here in New Zealand. He was a larger-than-life personality and was the driving force behind Shine Lawyers New Zealand. We're a specialist plaintiff litigation law firm with a core belief in standing up for the little guy. You may have heard some of our ads on the radio. Yep, we're that law firm. Shine plays our part in ensuring there is access to justice for all in New Zealand. We do a lot of work in the historic abuse space, and are paving the way to give victims back their voices. Andrew was a big believer in fighting for that guy. Being the best lawyer you could be, to have courage of your convictions, compassion for others, and a heart of service. We lost Andrew so suddenly and tragically in March 2020, just as the world was plunged into lockdown. But his legacy lives on in the values of our firm as we stand up for those who have no voice. I'm grateful for Andrew and for Shine for giving me the platform to help those people get their voices back. Now that you know my inspiration, now I turn and try to inspire you, the graduates. What UC has done is given you tools in your chosen craft, a different way to view the world, skills to be able to analyze, ways to think critically about the law and business and issues that matter. Now it is over to you to choose what you do with those tools and skills. I would encourage you to use them to make a positive difference in the world. But what kind of inspirational and motivational speaker would I be if I didn't give you some encouragements and some motivational cliches? After all, there's a reason they are cliches. That being said, as cliche as they ring true across professions and life seasons. No matter your beliefs and convictions, I believe now more than ever, our world needs kindness, compassion, wisdom, and light. Shine a light on the injustice of the world. Influence. Use your influence for good. It's so easy to judge people. I challenge you, be kind first. There are enough critics. Dare to be different. Instead of criticizing someone, edify them. If you end up being in a privileged position in your professional fields and being a leader in your field managing people, remember, people are your most valuable asset. Look after them and they will look after you. Understand the value of valuing people. Your mind is your most powerful ally, but it can also be your worst enemy. There is only one of you, so be the best version of you. Be unapologetically you. The world needs more of you. You are the only one that can do you, so do it well. You are fearfully and wonderfully made, and you have in your hands unique fingerprints, unique gifts and talents and abilities and quirks. Don't worry if you don't fit the mold, just do you. If you make a mistake, own up to it. We've all been there. We've all done it. Be honest, always, and never stop learning. To end, I leave you with three golden nuggets. And like every good lawyer, before I offer you these golden nuggets, I will hit you first with a disclaimer. While I'm not sure I'm qualified enough or old enough to give you any advice, but apparently I am, because one of the things that this has taught me is that I actually started back in UC 17 years ago, so clearly I am old enough. These golden nuggets are simply lessons that I have learned along the way. Having been a servant of the law and in my community for the better part of a decade, I leave you with these three lessons that I have learned in my 12 years of practice. First, and you'll all know this, nothing beats good old-fashioned hard work. This one is free from someone else who inspires me a lot, my mum. In Samoan, she says, "It's autala longadwenga," which means let the work of your hands speak for itself. Another goodie, and I'm quoting my dad far too much, be a good front rower. Ass up, head down, always gets results. There is honesty and integrity in working hard. Be that person. A good work ethic is a huge part of succeeding. But you all know that. That's why you're here graduating today. Golden nugget number two, back yourself. If you have done the work, you've read the cases, you understand the issues, you've drafted the business proposal, you've reviewed that proposal, you've considered the risks, you've triple-checked everything, chances are you're right. So back yourself. You might not get it right all the time, but that's okay. Have confidence in your abilities and that you really do know the answer. Have courage in your convictions and go for it. I must admit, of my 12 years of practice, I'm still working on this one. And finally, thirdly, no matter what the business, concern, issue, or legal problem you will face in your coming careers, the sun will always come up tomorrow. I'm not sure that I did a very good job at inspiring today, when I really am the one who is inspired by you, the graduates. Turns out that you guys have scaled something that not a lot of people before you have. Not only have you now reached the end of your academic journey, where you will have received your degrees and be let loose on the world, but you have overcome so much in the past few years to do that. COVID, border closures, lockdowns, separation from family and friends, dealing with a global pandemic and all that comes with it. And yet, here you are. Can I just ask you to take a moment to give yourself a huge round of applause for getting here today? Over and above all of that, many of you, I'm sure, also worked at some stage during your studies. Juggling a job and study is not an easy feat. Then there are also those of you who may have had families, children. Take it from me, that's not easy either. All of it is rewarding, but certainly not easy. So well done. You've managed to not only achieve and pass, but you've also overcome challenges in the school of life that I, for one, didn't face as a university student. So kudos to you. As they say in my mother tongue, ma lo lava le tawivi, ma lo le ngalue. May your future be full of happy coincidences, necessary failures, and all the success in the world. I congratulate you once again. Thank you for your attention. Soifua mai e manuia.
Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. I'm Cheryl Delaray, Vice-Chancellor Tumu Whakarau at the University of Canterbury. Tiffany, You ask the question, you're not sure if you're doing a good job. You did a splendid job. You inspired us by your experience, the golden nuggets, with a good dose of humour. Thank you very much. Please join me in thanking our speaker. To all our graduates and Yufano, again on behalf of the university community, congratulations on achieving a significant milestone in your life's journey. Today, you're marking the closure of one phase and the opening of another. As noted by our Chancellor, Amy Adams, you've had to dig deep and show extraordinary resilience and adaptability these past few years. We are very proud of your achievements. You have studied during a very volatile and unprecedented time. And during this time, we have all been impressed about in the ways in which our community has come together to support one another, to adapt, to overcome challenges over these past few years. I also took note of that proverb that Tiffany reminded us of, "It takes a village to raise a child." So in that spirit, I want to once again invite the graduates to express your appreciation for all of those who have supported you, your whānau, friends, the lecturers at the university, and all our university staff who have stood behind you and supported you throughout your studies. Let's thank them. We continue to navigate an unprecedented era in our human history. But as the world opens up again, there are many opportunities that await you, our graduates. We are confident that with a qualification from the University of Canterbury, as you've heard from our speaker, you are well prepared for your future career path and, importantly, to make a difference in our society. For those graduates who are moving on from the university, be assured that you will always be part of our community. As a graduate, you are now part of a 140,000 strong whānau of engaged and empowered University of Canterbury alumni. They're leading change in Aotearoa, in Samoa, and around the globe. We encourage you through our alumni office to stay in touch with us. Make sure that we have your contact details as these may change, as we look forward to seeing you at our future alumni events. Next year is an important year for our university. We will be marking our 150th anniversary. There will be many events across the city, here in Christchurch, locally, across our country, and internationally. Please join us at these events as we celebrate the resilience, adaptability, and responsiveness of our institution. Our very best wishes to you and for your future. As you continue to write the story of your lives, we urge you to make sure that the next chapter is worth reading for all the right reasons. Wherever the future may take you, use your talents, use your education, use your achievements to contribute to creating a world that gives greater priority to peace, to well-being, and sustainability. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. We have now come to the end of our formal proceedings. I invite all of us, if we are able, to stand as we sing Gaudiamus. The words can be found in the back of our programs. Assembled guests, as a way of honoring the achievements of our graduates, I shall ask all of you to continue standing while the academic procession and the graduates leave the auditorium. So now, if you are able, I invite you to stand. Nga mihi nui.